Dragon Ball Legends, you crafty hooligans, you. If you guys didn't know, Dragon Ball Legends post on their official Twitter account this tweet, 6 days till the third anniversary events, which would be the 30th, so get excited for that. We have the countdown in-game with that Goku event where we get a new free-to-play Goku every day, or at least you can, you know, begin to get them to 14 stars, a new one each day. And the main reason people are talking about this tweet, though, is this picture here, which, as you can see, it is a person juggling what seems to be 6 red balls. And now I've seen a lot of phenomenal theories and ideas out there. Someone posted the picture of 6th Path Sage Mode Naruto, and I mean, oh, there's zero chance it happens, but I would love a Naruto collab with Legends. I mean, I love Naruto is my favorite anime, so I would just love to get a, you know, Naruto characters. But then there's also Zenyatta from, you know, Overwatch, because he's got the orbs around him, and then he's in, like, you know, kind of like a yoga pose type thing. So, but those are just, you know, fun messing around. But the more serious theories on this are, we have Omega Shenron, Corrupted Zamasu, Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, and then Belmod, the clown god of destruction from Universe 11, Jiren's universe. And I'll just start with him because this is really simple. The reason some people say Belmod is just because juggling balls, and he's a clown. Clowns juggle balls. So that's literally it. That is the only reason people are saying Belmod. I would not be opposed to Tournament of Power, you know, having God of Destructions for the Universe Survival Saga buffs. They'd also buff God Key and the God of Destruction tags, because there's only Beerus and Champa so far, and there's some other ones. You know, there's Helena, is that? I feel like I always mess her name up. I think it's Helena from Universe 2, you know, the love one, the kind of like Egyptian-looking one. And there's other, you know, God of Destructions as well. And I wouldn't be against that if we got some God of Destructions. That'd be kind of cool, but I don't think it's going to be the case. As I've been explaining in my other videos talking about 3rd anniversary, I think it's super, super, super likely we're getting Future and GT again, running it back. I know some people are disappointed with that it's, you know, going to kind of be like the same thing as last year, especially if we get another Zamasu and Trunks, which this time it would be Corrupted Zamasu and then like a Sword of Hope Trunks, if it was something along those lines. With this picture, the other ideas of Omega Shenron is because when he gets, you know, blasted and all the Dragon Balls fly out of him, he has 7 Dragon Balls, though, unfortunately, and I guess technically there are 7 balls in this picture if you count his head along with the 6 red balls, but it's not 7 Dragon Balls, which would kind of be represented by the balls up here, and they definitely would not forget a ball, like, in their hints. They're too crafty for that. They're too crafty for that, so I don't think it's Omega Shenron depicted here in this picture. The other two are Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, who I feel like is a mortal lock. There's no way we ain't getting that guy for anniversary. It's just not. But the reason people say Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta is actually very similar to the Belmod theory of Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. When he appears, he's clowning around, you know, with Omega Shenron. And just because he's messing around, clowning around, juggling is clowning around. So Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta is from that. But the main one that I think actually is, like, the best idea, the best depiction here. Someone posted a picture of actually, I can't forget this idea. Sammy, my boy, you know, posted this. Garlic Jr., because Gresh has been saying Garlic Jr. for forever, you know, the Garlic Jr. meme. So, it does spell out garlic if you put one of the letters in each of the orbs there. But the main theory, which is the Corrupted Zamasu theory here, is a picture down here. Hold on, let's see. And there's the Naruto one that I was talking about, 6th Path Sage Naruto. But the reason I think this one is the best is because in this picture, it's from Fighters, this picture, but it's one of Zamasu's moves that I believe he uses in the anime in their fight. Here it is. It's from Break It Down posted this. Is because there's these red, well, you know, circles behind him. He's in the pose. You can see here in the picture here, there's the, you know, what the picture I'm comparing it to. There's the red circles. Obviously, they're not, you know, 6 aligned like that. But then he's got his arms out. He's even got one leg up, as you can see here, just like this picture has one leg up. Although I guess technically it's the other leg, but whatever, you get the idea. And I'd say this is the most similar looking thing we have to this in Dragon Ball. It just is. So I think Corrupted Zamasu is heavily hinted here. And actually this picture here, if it loads up here, this is from Dragon Ball Legends' official Instagram account. And it's the same picture, but they've added, you know, a background to it, and they put this text here. Can you guess? Which is in purple and pink coloration, which, for Corrupted Zamasu, that's kind of like his colors. You can see here, this is the Dokkan, you know, Zamasu. He's half purple. Y'all know that. Y'all know what he looks like. He's half purple. And then he commonly has pink in his background. Like here, that's the same picture, but it's, you know, the more blown up when he's got pink there. He's got the kind of pink aura here because, you know, rosé. I think this is just someone's fan edit, but again, they've got the theme, you know, going of the pink alongside it. And so this is really going in with the pink and purple idea of Corrupted Zamasu along with the picture, you know, that I just showed of this. I think this is the most, the best choice we have for what this picture is. Now, of course, we'll find out again on the 29th what actually is going on, but I would love to hear what your guys' thoughts are down below in the comments. Do you think this is a hint for Gogeta, Zamasu, Omega Shenron, Six Past Seijin with Naruto? What do you guys think this is a, you know, hint to? I think this is just the most likely because, again, as I've talked about, we've got so many hints towards future. I'm not even going to go through them all, but, you know, there's the Trap Banner, Goku Black being added to the story. Goku Black is part of Zamasu. And all of this, you know, wild, wild stuff. But I think it's future and GT again. We're going to get an LF Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta. It's again, mortal lock, locked in stone. This thing was written on stone tablets back in the, as old as time can be remembered. It was written on the caveman walls. The troglodytes of the past were drawn Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, Dragon Ball Legends 3rd anniversary on the walls. So I think Zamasu is going to be one of the other units. Don't know if he'll be an LF. If he was, that'd be pretty cool. But I think he'll be one of the LFs and this, or the other units, and this is what it's hinting to. So again, let me know in the comments down below. But if you enjoyed the video, slap a like, subscribe if you're new. I appreciate it very much. It means the world to me when you guys press that button. We're getting up there. We're almost on the way to 4K. That'd be pretty cool if we could hit 4K during this whole anniversary shenanigans. So press that subscribe button. But as always, hope y'all are staying happy and healthy out there. And I'll catch y'all tomorrow.